Breaking this morning, the catastrophic wildfires in Maui have now killed at least 55 people. The death toll rising again overnight as we get a better look at the damage.
Eyewitness News reporter Mark Cotarolis is live in studio with the very latest for us this morning. Mark.
At this time yesterday, the death toll was at 36. As you said, we now know of at least 55 people confirmed dead in Maui. It appears that most, if not all of those, were in the town of Lahaina. Hawaii's governor was able to tour that area.
It's a heartbreaking day, without a doubt. What we've seen today has been catastrophic, but we tell you there is going to be a team effort to bring our state back. What we saw was the utter devastation of Lahaina.
We are hearing more stories from Maui residents and tourists about the little warning they had to escape. There's apparently no indication that warning sirens were triggered. It's supposed to be the largest public safety warning system of its kind in the world, but many of Lahaina's survivors said they only realized they were in danger when they saw flames or heard explosions nearby. Many survivors say their only escape route was into the ocean.
There was no way to get out of Lahaina because of the traffic. See, because it was so dark, like it almost was like nighttime. So my girlfriend and I, we drove towards the water on the front street, right next to the Maui Outlet Center and the historical Longies. And pretty much everybody that was in that intersection jumped out of their cars and jumped into the ocean.
I want to add that man talked about his girlfriend there. He actually lost contact with her. He does not know where she is. Maui's fire chief said the fire moved so quickly it was impossible to get any messages to the agencies responsible for alerts. However, a spokesperson for Hawaii's Emergency Management Agency says Maui County did send alerts to cell phones, TVs, and radio stations. It's unclear if those alerts were sent before or after power and cell phone service was lost, meaning quite possibly those alerts were never received. The wildfire is already the state's deadliest natural disaster since the 1960 tsunami that killed 61 people on the Big Island. Meantime, the governor said the death toll will likely rise as the search operation continues.
Hello, I'm Mark Brown. Get more great ABC7 content by clicking the subscribe button for our YouTube channel. And download the ABC7 Los Angeles streaming app on Fire TV, Android TV, Apple TV, and Roku to watch on your TV.